In the previous video, we talked about how we will learn how to break down digital twin use cases. Now that's a big promise. So where do we even begin to start thinking on those terms? Well, we thought the best way would be to actually solve one together. We will take an industry use case and walk through it step by step to show you how the process works. Now typically, your digital twin starts with a 3D or 2D design model. So we did some model shopping and ended up with a 3D model of a house. It has a couple of floors and a bunch of utilities and furniture. Let's say a company comes to us and says that, hey, we want to build an iTwin application that can visualize and track, let's say, smart devices within a home. This could be a smart TV or smart lights and thermostats, stuff that they can get status information on through the cloud. I personally don't know anything about a smart home. I'm more of an old school caveman type of person. But let's say they sign up for an iTwin hackathon and they present us with this requirement and we have to learn how to do it. This is usually what one of these use case statements look like. Create a digital twin of a house model, visualize it within an iTwin app, pull data from an external data source that keeps track of smart devices within the house, and display the latest device statuses using markers. Now I know that's a mouthful, so let's break this statement down into parts. First step is to create a digital twin of a house model. What does that even mean, to create a digital twin of the house model? We talked about how engineering data traditionally is scattered in design files and there's no unifying place to keep a representation of it that could help maximize its potential. And that's one of the key features of the iTwin platform, is to take this design data and align it into a cloud-ready format so it can be consumed by digital twin applications. And that's where we can actually start having some fun with this data, such as adding the smart devices into it. So the first step is to push our design files, that is the house model, into what is called the AppModel Hub. It's kind of like the GitHub for infrastructure projects. It keeps track of all the design files and changes being pushed into your digital twin. Next up is visualize it within an iTwin app. Now once this data is on the hub, it can be consumed by iTwin applications. We can either use one that's already built or create our own custom application for our particular use case. The awesome thing here is that the iTwin platform supports cross-platform development. So you could reuse majority of the same code to build an application that is deployed in web, desktop, and mobile. This gives your custom application a high degree of accessibility. So we took data from all these different sources, put them in the cloud in one place, and now we can pull it in applications that are distributed in multiple platforms, thus enabling the data to shine its light in more places. Now this puts us in a really nice place to start extending this application. One of the key tenets of the idea of the digital twin is that it's extendable, that you're not limited to the data that you're starting with. Our house model can be embellished with additional data sources to enhance the value of its twin. We'll connect it to a cloud data source that keeps track of the smart devices in the house. And the best part is that all you need to know is some basic TypeScript and React, and you can start customizing your iTwin application and adding additional data sources as needed. Finally, once we have that smart device database connected to our digital twin, we can combine this data with the house model and start using some powerful visualization features that the iTwin platform offers. We can add things like decorators, heat maps, markers, tooltips, and even colorize, emphasize, and hide elements. Whatever we need to do to showcase parts of the model that would help us fulfill our use case. In this case, we will add markers to show the smart devices throughout the house and display their current statuses using tooltips. All these steps cover just a fraction of what the iTwin platform is capable of. We will go over some additional key platform features at the end of the course. The first step, though, for now, is to start with our house model, the DGN, and create its digital twin. So let's get that going in the next chapter. And we are really excited to be working with you on this project.